In the flesh, that through his death He might destroy him that had the power of death, that is the devil, and deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetimes subject to that bondage. You see, the Lord saw how we were all slaves to sin. The Lord saw how we were all in bondage to the lust of our own flesh. And that's why the Lord came bringing salvation better. The Lord came bringing deliverance. The scripture says here, for verily he took not on him the nature of angels, but he took on him the seed of Abraham. And this is what we're telling you today, men and brethren. We're saying, understand the will of God for your life in these last days. Let's take you to another scripture in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. The word of God says here, 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verses 2. The Apostle Paul speaking here, he says, for you know what commandments we gave you by the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, even your sanctification. That's the will of God for your life today, men and brethren. Your sanctification. It goes on to say that every one of you should abstain from fornication. That every one of you should know how to possess his vessel. That means your body in sanctification and in honor. But we're asking you today, men and brethren, who have believed this report? Who have believed this report of the sons of God? That God's will is for you to live holy. God's will is for you to live godly. God's will is for you to live without sin. Who have believed this report? That Christ came into the world, gave his life, died on Calvary's cross to bring about this salvation, to bring about this deliverance from sin and all unrighteousness. Who has believed our report? The word of God says here, this is the will of God, even your sanctification, that you shall abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and in honor, not in the lust of concupiscence, even as the Gentiles which know not God. And this is the problem with the world today, brethren. So many of you, you don't know God. You've heard of him, but you don't really know him. And this is what we were showing you even in the book of Romans chapter 10. The scripture says, how can you call on him in whom you don't really believe? We're saying to you today, men and brethren, if you still in sin, if you still love sin, if you still love unrighteousness, if you still love in your fornication, you know, that's any kind of sexual activity outside of marriage. If you're still loving adultery, you know, if you're still loving, you know, homosexuality and lesbianism, if you're still loving the liquor bottle, if you're still loving money, if you're still being covetous and envy and hateful of your neighbor, we're saying to you today, men and brethren, you don't really know God. We're saying to you today, God is light. God is righteousness, men and brethren. God is holiness. God is sanctification. God is liberty. I hear the word of God saying, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Liberty from what? Liberty from sin. Liberty from being in bondage to the devil. Liberty from being in bondage to the lust of your flesh. We're saying where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty today, brethren. The scripture says, And let's look in the book of Acts, chapter 17. The word of God declares. Acts chapter 17. This is that God that the world don't know. As we said, you might have heard of him, but you don't really know him if you're still in sin. The word of God tells me here in Acts chapter 17 and verses 23. This is the Apostle Paul speaking. He said, as I passed by and beheld your devotion, I found an altar with this inscription, to the unknown God, whom therefore you ignorantly worship, him declare I unto you. And that's who we labor to declare unto you today, brother. This God that you don't really know. This God that's about righteousness, as we showed you in Hebrews chapter 1. That God that loves righteousness. That God that hates iniquity. That hates sin. That hates the works of the devil. That's the God that we're speaking about to you today. Because a lot of you in false religion today, you might think that you're serving God. But if you're still in sin, men and brethren, you're serving another Jesus. You're worshiping another gospel. Even as we'll show you here in the book of Galatians chapter 1. The scripture says here in Galatians chapter 1. And verse, let's see, the scripture says here, verse 6, Paul again speaking here, he says, I marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. And that's what so many of you today have received, not the true gospel of Jesus Christ, not that true gospel that brings salvation and delivered from sin, but you're hearing another gospel. You're hearing about another Jesus, not the true Jesus that saves from sin. That Jesus that was spoken about in St. Matthew chapter 1, when the angel told Joseph, your wife Mary is going to bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. You're not hearing about this Jesus being preached in these false churches today, but you're hearing about another Jesus. Another Jesus where that you can continue in sin. Another Jesus where you can continue in adultery. Another Jesus where you can continue to be a fornicator. Another Jesus is what you're hearing in these false churches, where you can continue to hate one another and not labor to abide in that commandment of love that I heard the Lord telling his disciples in St. John chapter 15. The Lord says, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. And when you're talking about the love of God, men and brethren, God's love, I hear the word of God saying in Romans chapter 13, it don't work no ill unto his neighbor. God's love cannot sin against his neighbor. That's the difference between the love of God and the love of your flesh. The love of your flesh, it will grow cold against his neighbor. The love of your flesh, it can last for a while, but after a while, your love will grow cold, and then you'll sin against your neighbor. You'll commit adultery against your neighbor. You'll hate your neighbor in your heart. But the love of God is not the love of the flesh. The love of God don't grow cold. The love of God is eternal. The love of God, it endures all things. The love of God, it'll love his neighbor unto the end. Just like we saw in the example of our Lord Jesus Christ, how he loved us all the way to the death of the cross. We're telling you today, men and brethren, you gotta labor to examine yourself and make sure that you truly receive it. the truth of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is why we're here today, laboring to declare it unto you today, because we know that you're not hearing this kind of preaching in your Catholic church today. We already know you're not hearing this kind of sound doctrine being preached in your Baptist church. We already know you're not going to hear this kind of righteousness being preached in the Baptist church. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, you got to truly labor to be born again. I heard the Lord telling Nicodemus in St. John chapter 3, verily, verily, I say unto you, you must be born again. And we're not talking about just being born again, of just being dumped down in some water. That don't mean you've truly been born again. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, you got to labor to make sure that you have received the Spirit of God. Being born again of the Spirit of God. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, let's get back to Acts chapter 17. The Word of God says, verse 29, Acts chapter 17. The scripture says, for as much then as we are the offspring of God, we ought not to think that the Godhead is like gold or silver or stone, raised by art and man's device. We say you got to know what kind of sacrifice to give unto God in these last days. We're saying there's only one sacrifice that the Lord is looking for, and that's your body, men and brethren. You laboring to present your body unto God, holy and sanctified. The Word of God tells me in Romans chapter 12 that that is your reasonable service, that you labor today to present your body spotless unto God without sin. Your body spotless unto God without iniquity, men and brethren. We're saying to you today, I hear the Word of God saying, in 1 Peter, I believe it's chapter 1, it says, for as much as you know that you were not redeemed with corruptible things like silver and gold, received by vain tradition from your father, but we were redeemed by the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb slain, unspotted from the world. We're saying, men and brethren, that's the sacrifice that the Lord is looking for. You laboring to arm your mind, to suffer in your flesh, to that you might truly cease from sin. As the Lord told his disciples in St. Matthew chapter 16, the Lord was speaking with his disciples about how he was going to Jerusalem to give his life, to suffer. And as we showed you, men and brethren, in Hebrews chapter 2, the Lord's death on the cross, it was not for nothing. The Lord giving his life and suffering like that on Calvary's cross was for a reason. It was only that precious blood that could redeem us from sin, men and brethren. It was only that precious, holy, sanctified blood that could redeem us from all unrighteousness. And I heard the Lord telling his disciples in St. Matthew chapter 16, the Lord said, not only am I going to Jerusalem to suffer, but I heard the Lord saying to his disciples, except you pick up your cross and follow after me, you cannot be my disciple. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, that the Lord is asking you today to present your body as a living sacrifice unto God, which is your reasonable service. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, you got to understand this mystery. You got to understand, men and brethren, what it means to receive the Spirit of God. The scripture says, we can't think that the Godhead is like unto gold or silver or stone, graven by art and man's device. In the time of this ignorance, God winked at, but now is commanding all men everywhere to repent. We're saying to you today, men and brethren, the Lord is commanding all men everywhere to repent of their sins, to repent of all unrighteousness, to repent, men and brethren, of those works of your flesh, those works of the you got to come out of that unrighteousness. And you got to come learn about our Lord Jesus Christ. Learn how to live godly in your flesh. Learn how to offer unto God an acceptable sacrifice that God will receive, men and brethren. We're telling you today, we're going to give you one more scripture, and then we're going to turn it over to our other speaker. Let's look in Ephesians chapter 4 and verses 17. The word of God says, "This I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart." And this is what you see in the world today, men and brethren. This is what you find in these, even in these false churches. The flesh, they are alien from the life of God. The flesh, they've been alienated from this righteousness that the Lord came and died for, gave his life for. But the flesh in the world today, they've been alienated from the life of Christ. We're saying, men and brethren, who, the scripture goes on to say, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to work all uncleanness with greediness. But you have not so learned Christ, if so be that you have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that you put off concerning the former conversation that old man which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind. And this is what's supposed to take place, men and brethren, in the baptism. This is what it truly means to be born again of the Spirit of God. As we said, the Word of God shows not only being baptized in water, but you got to be baptized by the, in the Spirit of God. You got to be born again, men and brethren. The scripture says, as many of us as have been baptized into Jesus Christ, you should be laboring to put on Christ. That's how you know when you've truly been born again, men and brethren. The scripture says you got to labor to put off by faith that former conversation, that old man, that old creature that you used to be, that old creature that you were born with, that man of sin. When you come to Christ, you got to labor to put off that old creature, men and brethren. Put off that old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you put on that new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness, men and brethren. We're telling you today, men and brethren, you got to understand that the Lord is not playing with the sinner, men and brethren. There is no grace for the sinner. We're saying here, we're going to end up here back in Acts chapter 17. The scripture says the time of this ignorance, God might have winked that in times past. But now the Lord is commanding all men everywhere to repent, because he has appointed a day in the which he's going to judge the world in righteousness by that man whom he has ordained, whereof he has given assurance unto all men, and that he has raised him from the dead. Amen, brother. We hope that we said something that might have helped you today in your understanding, giving you a little more insight into the mind of Christ. And we say, men and brethren, the word of God tells me, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. We say, repent of your sins today, men and brethren. Repent and believe the true gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. That true gospel that can truly deliver you from sin. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, men and brethren. We are members of the Church of the Living God, and we are here today on your street corner to declare the unadulterated truth of the Word of God in these last days. As the minister was saying today, men and brethren, not many people know God's will for them in these last days. You have a lot of churches in this world. You have a lot of people calling themselves the prophets of God. Or they think that God has sent them because in order to have a Bible, because they went to school and got a degree. You know, to say that they are a pastor, to say that they have, you know, the knowledge to teach the Word of God. But I hear the Word of God says, men and brethren, in Romans chapter 10, as the minister read on this chapter here, we look at it again. It says, how can one preach except God sent him, men and brethren? It says here in Romans chapter 10, verses 14. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And we say in the world, and their false prophets don't really believe in God today. Why are we saying that today? It's because of their works. The Word of God says in Matthew chapter 7 today, men and brethren, you shall know them by the fruits that they do in their bodies by the grace of God. That's how we can come against the false prophets today. That's how we can speak against the Baptist church today and the Catholic church today. It's because of their works. It's because of their fruits, men and brethren. Let's look and see what the Word of God says here in Matthew chapter 7 about the fruits of their doing. Word of God says, Matthew chapter 7, verses 15. Beware of false prophets, men and brethren. This is why the Lord have ordained his body on the earth in these last days to go out to show the world the will of God, men and brethren. Because the world don't know God. They don't know how to worship God. They don't know how to work God's righteousness in their mortal flesh today. They don't know how to love their neighbor, even as God has loved us in these last days, men and brethren. That's why God has formed a body today on the earth, that they might go out to declare this truth. Well, God says, beware of those false prophets. We're telling you, your Baptist preacher is a false prophet, men and brethren. Your Catholic Pope is a false prophet. Because you look at the Catholic Church, they don't know God's will. You look at their works. You look at how they're molesting your little children, your little boys, and your little girls, men and brethren. You look at all that homosexuality in those Catholic faith, men and brethren. You look at adultery in the Baptist Church today, men and brethren. You look at boyfriends and girlfriends in the Baptist Church, in the Methodist Church today. Men and brethren, we're telling you, God is against fornication today. What if God says that you should be holy, you should be righteous, you should be godly in this present world. But because you're following a false prophet, because you have not heard the true prophet of God, that's why you're still in sin today. That's why you have a confession that you are a sinner saved by grace. But the grace of God is not for you to continue in sin. The grace of God is the power of God to turn away from the sin and the beggarly elements of this world, men and brethren. But the false prophets cannot teach the Word of God. Word of God says in Jeremiah chapter 23, if I have sent them, they would have turned you away from your sins. But because they just took their Bible and they're running, because God had not sent them, men and brethren. If God had sent them, they would have been teaching you how to turn away from sin, how to turn away from adultery and fornication. Young men, you don't just want to sleep around having sex outside of a true marriage. Young women don't know how to be sober today, how to be faithful and be a virgin until they marry on these last days, men and brethren. They want to show off their body today, but your body is for your husband, men and brethren. But the world don't know that. The false prophet cannot teach that, men and brethren. And this is why we're here today. That's where we come in, to shine the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ into this dark place in this world, men and brethren. Even in your conscience today, let the Word of God enter your conscience today. Have some faith that you might be washed
that you might be purged, that you might be clean, a new creature in Christ Jesus, men and brethren. But you don't have faith to repent. Repent from your sins today. Repent from your adultery today. Repent from fornication today. Repent from homosexuality today, men and brethren. What God says here, Matthew chapter 7, it says here, beware of the false prophets. Look at our works today. Look at what we're doing here today. We're trying to show you how to come out of sin. We're trying to show you how to serve God in spirit and in truth, but not in your flesh today, men and brethren. What God says, beware of the false prophets. Look at your Catholic priests, how they're molesting your little children. Look at your Catholic Pope, how he's just receiving these homosexuals or these pedophiles in their church. That's not the body of Christ, men and brethren. The body of Christ does not have any sin in him. The body of Christ cannot sin. The body of Christ doesn't involve itself in fornication, men and brethren. The body of Christ is holy, it's righteous, it's perfect, it's sanctified by the grace of God. But we say, look at the works of your preacher today. Look at the fruits of your preacher today. Look at the testimony that's coming out of his mouth. We are all sinners saved by grace. You know, the flesh is weak, but the spirit is willing. Yes, your flesh is weak. Yes, your flesh cannot live holy by itself. But God has sent forth his son in these last days. God has sent forth his only begotten son. What God says, if you would believe in Christ today, if you would lift up Christ in your body today, God can give you the power. God can give you the grace and the strength to overcome sin, to overcome fornication. You don't have to be in bondage to fornication, men and brethren. You don't have to be in bondage to adultery, where you cannot be faithful to your one wife. You cannot be faithful to your one husband. God has power. He's got grace. That's why he was made manifest in flesh and blood, that he might bring you this example, that he might bring you his grace, that he might take you out from under sin today by the grace of God. What God says here, Matthew chapter 7, beware of the false prophets, which come into you in sheep's clothing, saying, peace, peace, that's how the world is. The false prophets, they got all these smooth words, all these big words that you can't even understand, trying to make you feel good in your sins today. But God has come to put a separation here today. God has come to make a difference here today by the grace of God. And a difference between the Son of God and the son of the devil. The Son of God cannot sin. I hear what the God says in 1 John chapter 3. He that is born of God, he cannot sin, because the seed of God is abiding in him, and he cannot sin because he is born of God. But beware of these false prophets. They come to you in sheep's clothing. They say peace, peace to your sins. They're saying God loves everybody. But I hear what God says. God is angry at the sinner every day, men and brethren. God is angry at the wicked. God is angry at the fornicator. Those of you that want to have sex outside of a marriage, God is angry at the fornicator. God is angry at the adulterer, where you can't be faithful to your wife. You can't be faithful to your husband, where you want to put away your wife, putting away your husband, and remarry again a second time and a third time. God is angry at the adulterer today. What God says here, beware of those false prophets. They come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves, men and brethren. Satan doesn't have nothing good for you today, men and brethren. Satan is working in those false prophets, and Satan's desire for you is that you go to hell and the lake of fire with him. But I hear what God God says the gift of God, men and brethren, is eternal life. If you can have faith to receive this gospel today, you shall have eternal life by the grace of God. That's the gift of God. That's the gift that God has for us in these last days, having sent his son. If you can believe in his son today, if you can believe in the word of God today, you shall have that eternal life today also. Word of God says here, beware of those false prophets. Beware of your Baptist preacher. Beware of your Catholic priest, your Catholic pope. Beware of the Jewish synagogues. Beware of the Methodist church. Beware of the Seventh-day Adventist church, men and brethren. It says, they come into you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they're ravening wolves. It says, you shall know them by their fruits today, men and brethren. Look at their fruits. Look at their confession. They confessing that they are still a sinner. They confessing that Jesus Christ has not made manifest in their flesh. They confessing that Satan is over them today. They confessing that they got a sin, men and brethren. But the confession of the Son of God is that God has given us grace to turn away from sin. God has given us grace to love our one wife. God has given us grace to be perfect, even as he is perfect in these last days, men and brethren. That's why Titus chapter 2 shows us about the true grace of God, that true grace has appeared unto all men, that true grace has brought salvation. The true grace of God. Word of God says, don't take this grace in vain. If you still could be in sin, men and brethren, after you receive this grace, you have taken God's grace in vain. But we tell you today, by the grace of God, God's grace is to give you the power to turn away from sin, that you should live holy, that you should live godly, that you should live righteously in this present world. That means God's grace can give you power to put away the liquor bottle today. God's grace can give you power to put away the cigarette today. God's grace can give you power to put away the drug addiction today. God's grace can give you the power to put away all these sex outside of a true marriage today. God's grace can give you the power to love your neighbor as you love yourself today, men and brethren. That's what God's grace is all about. It's the power of God to live a life free from all sins, men and brethren. But beware of those false prophets that want to come to you and say, peace, peace to your sins. It's okay to divorce your wife. It's okay to divorce your husband. That's a lie, men and brethren. God is against the adulterer. God is against the fornicator today. It says, beware of those false prophets. You shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes or thorns or figs or thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, men and brethren. It's not just for a season that you can be holy. God said that my grace is going to keep you holy at all times by the grace of God. It says, every soul, even so, every good tree, bringeth forth good fruit, and a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. That's why the false prophets always have this confession that they're sinners saved by grace, because they're not of God, men and brethren. We look here in Jeremiah chapter 23 to give you a good understanding about the false prophets, men and brethren. How they're running. They're running 100 miles an hour, but they're not doing God's will. They're working in vain. The word of God says, if you follow them, they will fall into the ditch, and those that follow him will fall into the ditch also, men and brethren. That's why we tell you to come out from amongst them. Come out from among those false prophets and come follow after righteousness today. Let the righteousness of God draw you today. Let godliness draw you today. Let holiness and sanctification draw you today, men and brethren. Let the true word of God draw you in God's righteousness today. It says here in Jeremiah chapter 23, I have seen these prophets, how they prophesy lies, saying God has sent them, but it's not true. God have not sent the false prophet, men and brethren. Look at what they say. We weep to sin. God did not send Jesus Christ to show us that we have to continue in sin. Jesus Christ came to preach deliverance. Jesus Christ came to liberate us from sin. Jesus Christ came to give us power. Word of God says, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the light, men and brethren. Only by him can you be saved today. Only by Jesus Christ. If you have faith to believe in Jesus Christ today, we know by the grace of God, you will have life and have that life more abundantly. What of God says here in Jeremiah chapter 23, I've seen also of those prophets of Jerusalem in horrible things. They commit adultery. A lot of false prophets today in the Baptist church, they done put away their spouse and remarry again for a second time. Some of them have been married 3 or 4 times, yet they still think that they're the people of God. But men and brethren, look at their works. Look at what they're doing. Look at the example they're setting forth before you. I hear the word of God says in 1 Peter chapter 2, the Lord came to set forth an example. He did no sin, even though he was reviled against, even though he was threatened. The word of God says, he never speak back. He never take advantage of the grace of God. But he committed everything to him that have sent him by the grace of God. He set forth an example, even though, you know, he was tempted, the word of God says, but he never sinned. Even though he suffered in the flesh, he never sinned by the grace of God. That's the example we have to follow today. It says here, back in Jeremiah, chapter 23, it says, I've seen also in the prophets of Jerusalem, in horrible thing, they commit adultery. They walk in lies, men and brethren. They strengthen also the hands of evildoers. They're saying peace to your sins. They're saying it's okay, just pay your 10%. Just pay your tithes. But God is asking that you offer up your body as that living sacrifice. He doesn't care about your 10%. God don't need your 10%. I hear the word of God says, the cattle upon a thousand hills are mine. The Lord created the whole earth. The Lord created the universe. What of God says, if I were hungry, I would not tell you. God don't need a sacrifice from the sinner today, men and brethren. God is not looking for the worship of the sinner today. What of God says in John chapter 9, verse 31, God does not hear the prayer of a sinner. You see, you gotta have a desire to turn away from sin. You gotta have a desire to love righteousness, men and brethren. A desire to turn away from the beggarly elements of this world. Just because you're here doesn't mean you have to submit yourself to the beggarly elements of this world. But the word of God says here, by the grace of God, therefore, saith the Lord of hosts concerning these prophets, thank you, Jesus. What God says here, they're walking lies. They strengthen also the hands of the evildoers. That's what the false prophets are doing, men and brethren. They're making children of the devil. Instead of turning you away from sin, instead of showing you the will of God, they'd rather make merchandise of you. They're trying to rob you blind, but you can't see that. That they're robbing you, men and brethren. They always say, bring your 10%. Bring your tithes and offerings. As if God in need of your monies. God is not in need of your monies, men and brethren. What God says here in Romans chapter 12, I beseech you, brethren, that you offer up your body as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. Even Jeremiah chapter 7 shows that God never wants any sacrifice from anyone. But he says, the only thing that I want from you is that you obey my voice. That's what God is looking for, that you obey His voice. And what is the voice of God is saying today, men and brethren? God's voice is telling you to turn away from sin. God's voice today is telling you that you need to be born again. God's voice, this is the voice of God you're hearing today, men and brethren. You're hearing the word of God. You're hearing God's voice today telling you to repent from sin today. Repent from your adultery today. Repent from fornication today. Repent from your homosexuality today. Repent from lesbianism today. That's the voice of God telling you to turn away from sin and be born again and become a new creature in Christ Jesus. Repent from your sins today. What if God says, let he that nameth the name of Christ depart from iniquity. If you in sin today, you don't need to have God's name in your mouth today. You need to repent from sin first. You need to cast away the works of the flesh. Then God can give you grace, by the grace of God, to confess His name. God can give you grace to carry this testimony in your mouth today. But if you in sin, you don't need to call God's name. If you in sin, God is ashamed of you today. If you in fornication, God is ashamed of you today. God is angry at the wicked every day, the word of God says. What of God continue to say here? Jeremiah chapter 23. It says, Jeremiah chapter 23, they want to strengthen the hands of the evildoers. We're not trying to strengthen the hands of the homosexual today. We're telling the homosexuals, we're telling the adulterers, we're telling the fornicators, we're telling those that like the liquor bottle, those that like to smoke cigarettes, those that like to take drugs, those that are in bondage to sin today. All the sin, the word of God says, all unrighteousness is sin. Those that like to lie today. Those that can't love their neighbor today. We're not trying to strengthen your hand today. We're telling you to repent. We're telling you if you continue in your sins and die in your sins, you will open your eyes in hell in the lake of fire before an angry God by the grace of God. But today is a day of salvation. Today is a day of hope. Today is a day of opportunity where you can find that eternal life. Only if you can have faith to come and have fellowship with the body of Christ. We don't need your monies. We don't need your 10%, men and brethren. We're looking for those lost sheep of God. Those lost sheep that are astray even right now. We hope the word of God can find those lost sheep, men and brethren. We hope the word of God can search out these lost sheep, men and brethren. We're not looking for the sinner to come to worship God. The sinner cannot worship God. But you have to have a desire to turn away from sin by the grace of God. But the false prophets will tell you, just come and give your 10%. Just come and give your tithes. You know, then God will love you. God will receive you. That's a false prophet. That's a false prophet that don't know God. But they're greedy for Lucas' sake. They're greedy for your money. They're greedy for your goods, men and brethren. They want to rob you today. But what we want to do, we want to show you how to receive the salvation of God today. We want to show you how to receive God's righteousness today by the grace of God. We say here, back in Jeremiah chapter 23, it says, none doth return from his wickedness. See, the world is all about their flesh, about the word of God says, I believe, in Timothy. It says, in these last days, in perilous times, men gonna be lovers of themselves. You know, pleasures of this world, and love the pleasures of this world. But we say, men and brethren, that is not your calling. God didn't put you on this earth to fulfill your lust. What if God says, I believe in Isaiah, it says God created mankind to show forth his praise. God put you here on the earth to glorify him. Everything that God created, even the trees, everything that God created, men and brethren, even the grass, everything God created, even the birds in the air, even the fishes in the sea, even the sea itself, gotta glorify God, men and brethren. Everything that God has created, God says mankind should go forth and show forth his praise by the grace of God.
have you guys out here. You guys have a